Hi guys, so this is my second class on rooftop. Nice air flowing over here. Lot of drag force, viscous forces are acting. Okay guys, so now today we are going to start a new chapter in physics, in class 9th physics. Definitely it's a foundation part, not exactly class 9. It encompasses the total syllabus of ICSE, CBSE and a little bit of higher concepts which will be amalgamated with your syllabus in such a way that you will not understand. So what we are going to learn today? We are going to learn today about force. We are going to learn today about the precursors of Newton's laws of motion. We are going to learn today about different things that is happening around us. By our visualization power, we need to compare them or understand those things which are exactly happening but which we are not still sure of applying the principles of physics. We are going to apply the principles of physics and going to understand that. So that is our motto. Our motto is not to learn things. Our motto is to apply the principles of physics in real life. How do you do that? You do that basically by visualizing everything in a correct fashion. If you can visualize everything in a correct fashion, then it is super easy to apply principles of physics that we are learning. Like we have learnt about V is equal to U plus AT in laws of in normal equations of motion. We have learnt about V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. We have learnt about G, when it go upwards it becomes negative, it comes downwards it becomes positive. We have learnt about acceleration, we have learnt about deceleration. So it's time now to learn something about force. So the part is, foundation, aqua regia, physics, class 9th, okay, class 9th, and we are going to study our main thing, that is force. So before studying force, we need to understand what are the effects of force. Yes, effects of force. What is force basically? What is force? Force is something that causes a disturbance. Force is something that causes a disturbance. Like what? Like this duster is falling, I am stopping it. This duster was falling freely like this, I stopped it. So while it was falling freely without any thinking, I just stopped this path, I disturbed it. It is stationary, I throw it. It was very well, happy, stationary, I throw it, I disturbed it, right? The force is nothing but which causes disturbance. Now, definitely going by bookish term, we need to write that force changes state of rest or state of motion. How? Here is a car. Okay. So it is at rest. Rest means V is equal to 0. Velocity is 0. You give some force over here. Okay, sorry. My duster. You give some force over here, okay, and it starts moving, and now the velocity is not is equal to 0. So here what we did, we changed the state of rest to state of motion. We changed the state of rest to state of motion. That's what you did. Force changes state of rest, right? Now it is moving, I am applying some force. What happens after some time? What happens after some time? The velocity becomes 0. Again, khushi khushi tha, he was very happy. I pushed it, made it move. Then also it was moving, it was still happy. Now I stopped it, again I have caused disturbance. State of rest to state of motion to state of rest again. Okay, state of rest to state of motion to state of rest again. Okay guys, okay, next what it can do, it can do something else guys. Other than this, it can also change speed. It can change the speed. How? Okay, like this guys. Okay, it can, let's see this one. So here the velocity is say 2 meters per second. Velocity is nice air flowing guys, very nice. 2 meters per second velocity. I put some force on it. The car starts moving 4 meters per second. Changes the speed. Who affects this? Speed. Or you can say velocity. In this case, nothing changes. Okay? So you can write it as initial velocity, you can write it as final velocity. Okay? And you know, let's take 2 seconds in between these two. So you know V minus U is change in speed or change in velocity is 2 meters per second. What if somebody asks you about the acceleration? Acceleration is nothing but V minus U by T. So 2 by 2 meter per second and here second. So 1 meter per second square. So there is this vastu or there is this physical quantity which was caused by none other than force. So from here, from this one, this effect of force, we understand that force causes acceleration. It may be positive, it may be negative, but if there is a force, there will be acceleration. It may be positive, it may be negative, but if there is a force, there will be acceleration. Okay? Or retardation. Theek hai? Hoga. Okay, force can change speed or velocity. Now next, force changes direction of a body. Next part, very important things are going on of a body. How? Carom. You take a carom board. Say your dad or mother, whoever it is present at this moment who can play a little bit well, to strike one. At that same moment of time, this is moving. The guti is moving. Yes? You try to hit it, it is moving like this. You try to hit it from this angle. Believe me, my friend, if you can hit that at the same moment of time while it is moving, it will not go like this. It should have gone like this, but what will happen? It will move like this due to this hit. So it should have gone. If you have not hit this, it should have gone like this, but you have hit it like this, so it has gone like this. So basically it was going along the x-axis or horizontally, but you have given some vertical motion onto it, so it just changed its direction like this. So it changes the direction. Okay, it changes the direction. I can also show you another example. Like I take this shock over here, it is falling down, I change its direction, right? It was falling down, I changed its direction by my force. Okay, na direction change, niche gir raha tha, upar utha di. So that is nothing but how force changes the direction of a body. Theek hai? So I'll rub this now. Something else? Yes, it does change something else also. force does change something else also. It changes the dimension of body, dimensions of a body. Example, okay, you take a sponge like this, a put some force like this onto it, what it will become? It will become like this because you have put some force. So it is getting deformed. So basically shape and size of a body can also be changed by force, like this one. This is not a sponge exactly. Okay, I'll take this one. You can see this, this is a sponge. I can change the shape, right? I can change the shape. So it can also change the dimension of a body. So before we go into anything else, we need to know something about bodies. We need to know something about bodies. See, normally bodies are of two types, okay? One is rigid body, another is non-rigid body. So these are the bodies. So one is rigid, another is non-rigid. So for a rigid body, what happens? For a rigid body, what happens? What is rigid body? See, if I draw a body like this and consider it as perfectly rigid, and if there is a particle inside this body as A, random particle, and B, and there is a distance that is called interparticle distance, which I call interparticle distance. Interparticle distance. Now, if it is a rigid body, this interparticle distance, this d, never changes on application of force. D will never change on application of a force if it is a perfectly rigid body. So in a rigid body, this interparticle distance never changes on application of force. So in a rigid body, if you give some force, then what will happen? You can change the state, change state of rest or motion. You can change the state of rest or motion. Number two, you can also change the direction of the body. Definitely, direction of body, this can also be changed. You can change the state of rest to motion, motion to rest, change the velocity, change the direction of the body, anything you can do, but you cannot deform this body. The dimensions cannot be changed. The dimensions of the body cannot be changed for a rigid body. If you consider this chalk as rigid, however I, how much I press this, I cannot change the dimension until and unless I break it. Until and unless I break it. Okay? So, understood? What is rigid body? Now, what is non-rigid body? In a non-rigid body, definitely this D changes on application of force. So what force, what effects that does force bring on this kind of body? Change of state, of rest or motion. Change of state of rest or motion. Number two, it can change your direction. It can change the velocity and it can also change the dimensions. Okay. Non-rigid body means the sponge is a non-rigid body. You can change its dimension like this. Okay. Remember, my dear friends, there is no body in the world that is perfectly rigid. Everybody can be deformed. Okay. So there is no such perfect rigid concept is there. But however, why we are studying this is because we need to know the differences between these two extremes so that we can calculate various deformations and everything according to the material we are handling. Okay? So, koi jyada rigid hai, koi kam rigid hai, but जानना पड़ेगा ना किसका रिजिडिटी कितना है. व्हाट इज फिजिक्स? फिजिक्स इज नॉट अबाउट नोइंग व्हाट इज रिजिड व्हाट इज नॉन रिजिड. फिजिक्स इज अबाउट पुटिंग सम नंबर टू इट सो दैट यू कैन मेजर द रिजिडिटी ऑफ ए बॉडी. ठीक है, क्लियर गाइस? सो दैट इज ऑल अबाउट द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ फोर्स दैट आई वॉन्टेड टू डिस्कस. After this, many interesting topics are definitely coming on your way. But this is very important part because this just paves the path for you to understand different kind of forces that we are going to study just after this. Thank you. Hello. So we are going to now dig a little deep inside the force part so that we understand what is force before going into different kind of forces that we are going to study about, like frictional forces and all those things are there. So before that, we need to study a little bit about forces and where does this apply. We are basically studying about Newton's laws of motion. The chapter is called Newton's laws of motion, so definitely we need to know something that where this Newton's laws of motion are applicable, where this is not applicable. So those important nuances we are going to discuss in this short video. We're making it very short because this is for lower classes. Okay, so first, what is force? Force is nothing but it is, force is what you should write. Okay, a physical quantity. That is the best one, right? Force is a physical quantity. Okay, I'll write it this part only. That changes or tends to change size and shape of a body. Also, it can change state of rest or motion. So this is basically force. Force can change state of rest and change of state of motion. Force can change the dimensions of a body. It can change the direction also. So you may add the direction part here also. Okay, it's not in the definition, but you can add this direction of the body. So direction of a nice air again. Direction of the body can also be changed by force. Okay, so that is very important. Now, mathematically, what is force that we need to know? Mathematically, force is a vector quantity. It is equal to mass. Mass is a scalar quantity into acceleration. Previously, we have already studied that when there is a force, there will be acceleration. Force causes acceleration of a body. Force causes acceleration of a body, and force is equal to mass into acceleration. Okay. Now, what are important things? This is a vector quantity. First of all, very important. That's why I have shown this arrow over here. It is a vector quantity. Very important. Next, what should be its unit? Now, the mass unit is kg into acceleration unit is meter per second square. So, force unit is nothing but kg meter per second square. Together, it is called Newton. Denoted by capital N, and it is the SI unit. Okay, it is the SI unit of force. CGS unit of force is dyne. CGS unit of force. Sometimes a conversion is asked to change it to dyne. So how do you change it? What is 1 newton? 1 newton is 1 kg into 1 meter per second square. So here you can write it as, what is dyne first of all? Dyne is just converted into CGS. Newton is what? Kg. So kg ke matlab gram ho jayega. And meter will become centimeter. So gram, centimeter, second square. Okay? Second minus 2. So here it is 1000 gram definitely. Into 1 meter means 100 centimeter. Second square remains as it is. It is second square there also. So you can see here it is nothing but 10 to the power 5 gram. Centimeter second minus 2, so it is 10 to the power 5 dyne. Now if you want to give some slangs to somebody, you can call them Newton, okay? Because 1 Newton is equal to 10 to the power 5 dyne. Samajh lo. Okay? Now, this relation F is equal to MA, okay, this relation was first studied by none other than Sir Isaac Newton. Okay, this was first studied by none other than Isaac Newton. And study about this relation, study about this relation is called Newtonian mechanics. Newtonian mechanics. ठीक है, स्टडी अबाउट दिस रिलेशन इज कॉल्ड न्यूटोनियन मैकेनिक्स. नाउ इफ सपोज वी आर स्टडिंग ए पार्टिकल हु स्पीड इज कंपेरेबल टू स्पीड ऑफ लाइट, देन दिस न्यूटोनियन मैकेनिक्स इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय आइंस्टाइन्स थियोरी of relativity, because in this case mass and energy are interconvertible when the particle moves in a speed very close to light. Okay, this is much more comprehensive theory than Newtonian mechanics, but applicable when speed is equal to or very near to the speed of light. So when a particle is moving at a speed very near to speed of light, Newtonian mechanics is invalid. Okay, you have to use Einstein's theory of relativity. Next, if the particle size is very small, like that of an electron, you can understand we are talking about subatomic particles over here, then this Newtonian mechanics again gets replaced by quantum mechanics. Again, a very much comprehensive theory than Newtonian mechanics. This happens because when we are talking about subatomic particles like electron, they do not only have particle character, they also have wave character. So you are going to study this in a little bit more detail when you study a little bit in class 11th chemistry. You have all those things, and in class 12th physics also you have this quantum physics. So in there you are going to study a little bit about both these theories, basically quantum mechanics and Einstein's theory of relativity, both are there. So there on you will be studying all these things, but first of all you need to understand speed of the light ke aas paas mein agar koi speed hai to wo Einstein's theory of relativity ke sath wo chala jayega, and we are not going to apply Newtonian mechanics or Newton's laws of motion there, and this relation will be invalid. And particle size agar bahut chota hota hai, if it is very small the particle size as like electron, then definitely we have to go in Sharon of quantum mechanics rather than going for Newtonian mechanics. But then why we are studying Newtonian mechanics? Because in our life most of the particles are not as small as electron, and most of the particles are not speeding like velocity of light. Okay, so most of them are normal like us, and for people like us Newtonian mechanics works very well, because Newtonian mechanics is very well valid. A little bit more than the structure of atom size. Okay, so atomic subatomic particles agar thoda sa bada hoga to it is valid, Newtonian mechanics is valid, and also up to astronomical size it is valid. So it covers an wide array of particles that is exactly at this moment in this room, in your room, and wherever you can see. So definitely Newtonian mechanics is much more important and is very important to study in detail, and that is what we are going to do in starting from class 9. Thank you guys. Coming up with different kind of forces after this.